Good morning all. Today we will discuss electronic specific heat or specific capacity of electron gas. According to classical statistical mechanics, if a particle is free, then its energy is 3 by 2 kBT, where kB is Boltzmann's constant. If there are n atoms and each atom is contributing one electron, then its energy can be written as 3 by 2 nkbT. Specific capacity, electronic specific capacity is dou E by dou T. Taking the differential, we will be getting 3 by 2 nkb. But the experimentally observed value is much less than this calculated value. It is less by a factor of 0.01. This discrepancy can be removed by assuming the following things. We have the density of states as GE equal to V by 2 pi square 2m by h bar square the whole raised to 3 by 2 e raised to 1 by 2. So density of states proportional to e raised to 1 by 2. Consider the variation of density of states with the energy. So it is proportional to e raised to 1 by 2. So the graph is a parabola like this. So at E equal to EF, when temperature T equal to 0, all the energy levels below Fermi level will be filled. So this shaded portion represents the occupied energy levels at T equal to 0, and all the energy levels above Fermi level will be vacant. When temperature greater than 0, some electrons can jump from lower energy state to higher energy state. So the occupancy is, probability of occupancy is represented by the dotted line. This is for T equal to 0 and this one is for T greater than 0. When the temperature is greater than 0, some energy levels are occupied, and this energy level, this is in the range kBT. So in classical theory, we have assumed that all the electrons are absorbing an energy 3 by 2 kBT. But in this case, only the electrons having energy in the range kBT, which is having energy of the order of kBT, are excited. So the energy levels near the Fermi level, which is having energy in the range kBT, are excited to higher states. So the fraction of electrons excited can be written as kBT by EF. This is the fraction of electrons excited to higher state. If there are n number of electrons, then the number of electrons excited to higher state is nkBT by EF. EF we can write it as kB into TF, where TF is called Fermi temperature. It is Fermi temperature. So it is equal to N into, instead of EF, kB TF, then it will be T by TF. Even though we are having N electrons, only N into T by TF electrons will be excited, will be absorbing an energy 3 by 2 kT. So the energy can be written as N T by TF into 3 by 2 kBT. So it will be 3 by 2 NK, KB I am writing as K, into T square by TF. Taking the differential of this one, we will get the electronic specific capacity. So C electronic equal to T square, differential with respect to T, it is 2T, so 2 will get cancelled. Then we will be getting 3 nkT by TF. So this is the electronic specific capacity. At room temperature, this electronic specific capacity matches very well with the experimentally observed value. So the electronic specific capacity, we are getting it as proportional to absolute temperature. Now we will calculate the electronic specific capacity at a very low temperature, KT very less than EF. when t equal to 0, the energy, I am writing it as E0. E0 equal to average energy density of states is given by GE. It is the number of states per unit energy level. So, if we are having energy level dE between E and E plus dE, then the number of states available between E and E plus dE will be GEDE, which represents the number of orbitals present in energy range E and E plus dE. So, the occupancy, probability of occupancy of each state is given by FE. So, this represents the number of states occupied, and each state is having an energy E. So, this represents the number of electrons in energy level E and E plus dE. So, the total energy we can get it by integrating. This is at t equal to 0. At t equal to 0, only the energy levels below Fermi level will be filled. So, we can take the integration limit from 0 to F, and the probability of occupancy, F is equal to 1 when t equal to 0 and the energy is less than Fermi energy. So, we can write E0 as integral 0 to EF, E, F of E is 1, then GE, DE. So, F of E, we know F of E, 1 by E raised to E minus mu by KT plus 1. When E equal to EF, this can be written as chemical potential, can be written as Fermi energy EF. So, it is FE equal to 1 by E raised to E minus EF by KT plus 1. Its variation with energy, F of E versus energy. When E equal to EF, the probability of occupancy is 1, and above that the probability of occupancy is 0. This is for T equal to 0. When T greater than 0, the probability of occupancy is like this. The levels above Fermi energy will be occupied when temperature greater than 0. So, this term F of E depends on temperature. So, when we are taking energy at 0, F of E is 1. So, it is independent of F of E, which is equal to 1. And this term is independent of temperature. So, we can write dou E0 by dou T as 0. The energy at temperature T can be written as ET. At temperature T, above Fermi level will be occupied. So, the integration limit, we can write it as from 0 to infinity instead of 0 to F. Then E, F of E is not 1. So, it is F of E, GE, DE. So, this represents the energy at temperature T equal to at temperature T. So, when we increase the temperature from 0 to T, the energy difference, we can write it as E equal to ET minus E0. Taking the differential of this one, dou E by dou T will give the electronic specific capacity. So, when we take dou E by dou T, dou E0 by dou T is 0. So, we can write it as dou ET by dou T. What is dou ET by dou T? ET is this one. Temperature dependent term is F. So, we can write dou F by dou T. So, taking the differential of this equation, we can write it as 0 to infinity E GE DE dou F by dot, and taking this as equation number 1. Now, we know n equal to integral g, number of states available is GEDE. And the probability of occupancy is F of E. So, the total number of states is F of E, GEDE, integration limit from 0 to infinity. This is same as integral 0 to EF. When we take up to Fermi energy, when we take temperature T equal to 0, we only need to integrate up to Fermi energy. So, F of E will be 1, then it will be GEDE. This represents the number of states, total number of electrons. Total number of electrons remains the same. Since total number of electrons remains the same, dou n by dou t will be 0. multiplying this term by EF. When we multiply this by EF, EF into N is equal to, since EF is constant, I am writing it inside, then it will be 0 to infinity EF F of E GE DE. Taking the differential of this one, EF is constant. So when we take the differential of this one, we can write EF dou N by dou T. Here the temperature dependent term is F. So I am writing it at the last. So here EF, then GE DE dou F by dou T. N is constant, so dou N by dou T equal to 0. So this should be equal to 0. So we can write the left hand side of this equation as 0. This is 0. Equation number 2. Taking the difference of 1 and 2, 1 minus 2 gives. When we take the difference of these two, we can write this as 0 equal to right hand side, this is E, then here it is F. So the difference is integral 0 to infinity E minus EF, then GE DE dou F by dou T. So this is the electronic specific capacity. Then we know that the variation of Fermi Dirac distribution with function with the temperature, it is significant only at E equal to EF. It is considerable only at E equal to EF. When E equal to EF, GE, we can write it as GE equal to GEF, which is equal to a constant. So we can take this term outside, since dou F by dou T is considerable at E equal to EF. So taking this term outside and substituting EF instead of E, then it will be GEF integral 0 to infinity E minus EF DE dou F by dou T. Now take the differential of F with respect to T. F is given by 1 by E raised to E minus mu by kT plus 1. It's differentially significant when E equal to EF. So we can write this equation as F as, we can write it as at T equal to T very very less than, we are considering temperature kT very very less than EF. So when T tends to 0, we can write chemical potential as EF. So it is 1 by E raised to E minus EF by kT plus 1. Dou F by dou T will be minus 1 by this denominator its square into differential of this one, E raised to E minus EF by kT into differential of this one with respect to T. It will be E minus into E minus EF by K into 1 by T differential minus 1 by T square. So it will be E minus EF by K T square E raised to E minus EF by K T by E raised to E minus EF by K T plus 1 the whole square. Substituting this value here, we get it as GEF equal to GEF into integral 0 to infinity E minus EF, here on E minus EF is there, so square by KT square E raised to E minus EF by KT divided by E raised to E minus EF by KT plus 1 the whole square DE. For simplifying this, we will assume x equal to, let x equal to E minus EF by KT. Then E minus EF is KT x, DE is KT dx. Substituting this value here, the integration limit is from 0 to infinity. Minus infinity to 0, this function is 0. So we can take the integral from minus infinity to plus infinity. GEF minus infinity to plus infinity. E minus EF, it is k square t square x square by k t square e raised to x instead of dE, k t dx by e raised to x plus 1 the whole square. Taking the constants outside, GEF into k get cancelled, then t square, k, k, then it will be k square t, then integral minus infinity to plus infinity, x square e raised to x dx by e raised to x plus 1 the whole square. This integral is a standard integral and its value is pi square by 3. So we can write the electronic specific capacity as GEF into k square t then into pi square by 3. I am taking this as equation number 3. Now we need the equation for GEF in terms of Fermi energy EF. So GE is given by V by 2 pi square 2m by h bar square the whole raised to 3 by 2 into e raised to 1 by 2. Number of electrons is given by integral 0 to EF GE dE. T equal to 0, so it is GE dE. F of E is 1, integration limit is from 0 to EF. When we integrate this term from 0 to EF, then it will be e raised to 1 by 2. Integral of e raised to 1 by 2 dE from 0 to EF. It will be e raised to 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. So the n will be V by 2 pi square 2m by h bar square the whole raised to 3 by 2 EF raised to 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. Or it will be into 2 by 3. Then GEF, substituting E, replacing E by EF, then it will be V by 2 pi square 2m by h bar square the whole raised to 3 by 2 EF raised to 1 by 2. Taking the ratio of these two equations, GEF by N equal to, taking the ratio, then this constant will get cancelled, then EF raised to 1 by 2 by EF raised to 3 by 2. Then it will be 3 by 2 EF, or we are getting EF, GEF as 3N by 2 EF. Substitute this value in equation 3, we get the electronic specific heat as C electronic equal to 3N by 2 EF into k square t into pi square by 3. So this 3 will get cancelled. Then it will be pi square by 2 n k square t by EF. This is the expression for electronic specific capacity. We know that the Fermi energy EF is equal to K into TF, where TF is Fermi energy, sorry, Fermi temperature. Then electronic specific capacity is pi square by 2. Then K will get cancelled. We get NK T by TF. This is the expression for electronic specific capacity. Nk, for 1 mole we can write Nk as, for 1 mole, if we take 1 mole we can write Nk as R. So from this we get electronic specific capacity is proportional to absolute temperature. This is the expression for electronic specific capacity at a very low temperature. we can write the specific capacity of a solid as, specific capacity of a solid is contribution of specific capacity due to lattice plus specific capacity due to electronic. So it is sum of electronic and the lattice specific capacities. At a low temperature, the lattice specific capacity is given by d by T cube law. So C lattice is proportional to T cube, or we can write C lattice equal to A into T cube. Electronic specific capacity, C electronic, we now derived the equation C electronic proportional to T, or C electronic equal to gamma into T, where A and gamma are constants. So the specific capacity of a solid can be written as electronic specific capacity gamma T plus lattice specific capacity A into T cube, or we can write Cv by T as gamma plus A T square. So this is the specific capacity of a solid. When we draw a graph by taking Cv by T along y axis and T square along x axis, this y equal to mx plus c, it is a expression for straight line, so we will be getting a straight line. The y intercept gives the value of gamma, and the slope of graph gives the value of A. This value is very much in agreement with the experimentally observed value. So this is the expression for heat capacity of a solid. Thank you.